Welcome everyone. I wanted to do a quick use case video. This is a use case that I've been thinking about for the past 6 to 8 months. I wanted to expand on it a little bit, and I think that this is going to be a prime solution and a prime use case for the Cardano blockchain. And it's all about identity verification. I think that this is going to be huge for distributed ledger technology into the future, and a company that builds this correct is going to revolutionize the game. And what do I mean by identity verification? Well, what I had in mind is we're going to take a government institution or a government entity. Let's take the TSA, for example. The TSA is responsible for airport screening. It's an agency within the United States, and they're all about security for transportation. And one thing that I noticed is that when you travel, there are a lot of bottlenecks in the traveling process. So you can get things in the United States called TSA PreCheck or Global Entry. And basically, these are badges that allow you to travel domestically and internationally with ease. You register your fingerprints and you register all your information into a central database. You go to an airport or location, they have a quick interview with you. And this allows you to bypass some lines and travel quicker. And I think that it's very important in order to track people going from country A to country B. But in the future, we're living in tumultuous times, and one day of the week, this country bans this passport. Another day of the week, another country bans this passport. There's constantly friends becoming enemies and enemies becoming friends. So it makes it difficult for the end user or the end traveler to travel in peace. And I think that the government in the future will be looking for solutions to put identity verification within a blockchain. And similar to, I think this would probably work best as like an Atala project, building their own centralized blockchain within Cardano. And I think that this could highly benefit ADA in the future, because what's going to end up happening is the government would be the verifier in this particular use case. So maybe you'd have your passport and you have a QR code on the passport, and that connected them to the centralized blockchain, and all your information was there. So they didn't have to ask you questions like, did you go to this country or did you go to this country? Or they didn't have to fidget through your passport and look for the latest stamps. Maybe it could be an electronic stamp. Maybe you could still get a physical stamp. Save a whole bunch of time and the lines would go a lot quicker. And all the information that the government would need would be right there. And then if you have the TSA doing something like this on a centralized blockchain, and maybe another company, a third party, for example, like Clear, does another version of this, and they're all competing with the government-provided solution, and they put their centralized server on a blockchain as well. Let's say they use Cardano and they have this Clear transportation app where you can scan your passport in a Clear line and go through the line relatively quickly. Now, let's say that Clear, a third party, all of a sudden says, yes, we accept euros, we accept yen, we accept USD, we accept Australian dollars, we accept rand, South African rand, but now we're going to accept ADA. So you'll be able to communicate in the decentralized blockchain and pay for your services within a centralized blockchain. But as soon as they accept ADA, that immediately requires the end party to receive ADA. And all of a sudden, the link between the centralized and the decentralized blockchain is broken, and there's going to be money flowing from blockchain A to blockchain B. And they're going to have hold-to-hold reserves in order to maybe compensate people for refunds and whatnot. And all of a sudden, there's just communication. And those third-party solutions are all of a sudden going to pressure the original solution or the original government solution to accept ADA as well. So this is what is going to happen with Atala. If these centralized blockchains are built correctly and the government feels completely safe in building their solutions on this blockchain, they're going to 100% interoperate with decentralized blockchains. I think that's what's going to provide, that's what's going to happen, because there's money in that. Having a closed loop system where you're only participating within the centralized blockchain, what happens when you want to accept different currencies for different things? So I think that this is going to be I don't think that they're ever going to be fully decentralized, but I think that they're going to be accepting currency from a decentralized blockchain. And that's really all we need for price appreciation within ADA or within Cardano. So let me know what you think about this identity verification. And it could be anything from a passport to a driver's license. I know I go to the DMV. I have a driver's license, and it's from when I was a teenager, when I first learned how to drive. I think I was 16 years old, got my license, and the same picture on my license, when I've had to renew my license, the same picture goes onto the next license. I could change the picture and put it on the new license. But the issue is, I'm not going to go to the DMV and wait 4 hours to change a picture. But what happens is, when I go to locations, people look at the photo and they have to double take. And they ask me all these questions. What if there was a little QR code on that driver's license that answered all the questions that they had? And this way it would save time. So instead of them taking a minute to see each person, all of a sudden it's 10, 15 seconds. Money's spent. Every second that people waste at an airport or waiting in line for something is another second wasted in potentially spending money. And we're moving towards a system which is quicker, faster, easier to access. You can pay with your phone now. You can order stuff on Amazon, next day air. Things are getting quicker and quicker. This is what's going to allow the system to continue being fluid. And I think Cardano is primed to provide the solutions for these governments that are looking for applications in distributed ledger technology. And I think that moving forward, they're going to be working with the most secure blockchains, not the ones where they feel like data can be compromised or funds can be compromised. Because I don't think the government of Ethiopia or the government of the United States is going to work with a cryptocurrency or a blockchain and put serious resources behind it if they think that somehow the money can be hacked or the information can be compromised. I just don't think it's going to happen. A DAO hack of people's information, I don't think it's going to happen. And, you know, Ethereum may shape up and create these solutions to provide a little bit more ease of use for government solutions, but Cardano will be prime in competing for these contracts. And I look forward to seeing where I can insert myself in that space in the future, because I have a lot of ideas, and I think that they could revolutionize the Cardano blockchain. All right, until the next video, thank you.